G-Man and Faulty Cell are in fact the only maintainers of this phone. There is no official development going on for this phone. I'm talking about the G320FN. We were very happy when we received Lineage OS, and G-Man and Faulty Cell, they started with a Lineage OS project. And you know what I like from these guys? They keep updating it. Here in my hands, I have the latest version of Lineage OS 14.1 that I modded to be some Oreo Pi remix, something beautiful I created from it. But of course, the engine is by Faulty Cell and G-Man, so let that be very well understood. What I did, I gifted the look and feels that it deserves, okay? So let me bring you a little bit closer. Let me show you what it is, and then we're gonna install it. I'm gonna show you how to install it. And yeah, yo guys, this is really only for the G320FN. The phone was created somewhere in 2016, and this is what we're gonna get. Okay, when we're done with everything, then this is what we will have in our hands, peeps. A beautiful, good-looking Android 7.12. Okay, so this is not Nougat, this is not Oreo, but look at the security patches up to the 5th of December 2018. Many phones don't have these latest security patches. Okay, we have some others were released somewhere in February, but that ROM is I'm sure they are working on that. Okay, but this is the very latest that you can get for this phone, and it was released on Lundi, that is Monday, the 4th of February, that is February 2019. Okay, so merci beaucoup, mon ami, G-Man and Faulty Cell. Très, très belle. Travaille très bien, très bon. And aussi la caméra, c'est bon. Tout travaille très, très joli. I'm saying that everything is working very nice. You can make videos. You can, do many things out of the box with this ROM, okay? But you're gonna have two links. I'm gonna have the link to the XDA of Faulty Cell and G-Man, where you can download the original ROM from these guys, or the same ROM, but then with, all these extras implemented, so you can get started immediately. And I pushed in my peps. These are fantastic, cool applications, including a very strong ultra firewall. Yeah, and thanks to having root, you will also be able to protect yourself in a very fantastic way. Okay, so let's go ahead and install it. You will need twerp. You can get the twerp from the website of Faulty Cell and G-Man. I'm gonna restart in the recovery mode. This you can set up in the developers options. Just type tap on the build number 8 times, and then you will have developers options enabled. Go in there and turn on advanced reboot. Okay, so let me show you what it is. We're just gonna do a wipe, and I have a little issue with the touch in the recovery. I don't know if this is the recovery itself that is effect messing up. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a wipe. I'm gonna wipe the operating system. And it says mount, unable to mount storage. It's all good. And we're gonna install. And we go up a level. And we go down. SD card. We go down. And there is the ROM. You see, it's the Oreo Pi Remix mod. And we're gonna install it. Okay? So let's go. Come on. There we go. We're installing. And I'm gonna show it you real time so you have an idea of what you can expect. The tar file, the twerp, you can get from the XDA of these guys. Download it. Find a Windows machine with Auden. I have one there. You see that? With Auden open. I did a complete clean install. I wiped the internal drive as well. So yeah, it's crying about storage there. Don't worry about it. And we're gonna install one more thing, and that is Magisk. So we will have root access. And there we go. And I don't know what is this mount storage. Let me take a look at that real fast. Mount system EFS. Yeah, that's fine. Home, reboot, system. And there we go. Should boot up anytime from now. There we go. And this is the Google Pi boot animation, Android 9. Okay, this is not Android 9, guys. This is Nougat. It's Lineage OS 14.1, released in February last month. And this is, in fact, the latest and I think the greatest version that you can get at this moment for this phone. Okay, I've played a bit with it already and I saw that it was very stable. So great thumbs up there to G-Man and Faulty Sal. This ROM is as well from you guys, so just link it, copy it from my Google account to yours and share it as well on your XDA if you wish. That's all good, because in fact they did the developing of the ROM and the updating and I just did the cosmetic part of it, you know, boot animation, the applications that I think that are good, that I test for over 2 years now. We have a built-in app store powered by APK Pure. That one you might have to update whenever you're gonna connect. It will say a new version available. Just update it and you'll be good to go. It's a great application store. I don't find no viruses and bloodware in there. I do find lots of applications, of course, with advertisements, but you can see it immediately. Whenever you look for an app, then you can see if it's also coming with advertisements. And the coolest is that we have many cool application developers that don't put advertisements, eh? They just create the application and they put it out there. We also have F-Droid installed. F-Droid is in fact an application store from, you know, developers, independent developers. And these guys, yeah, they create fantastic launchers and applications and all sorts of things that you would not think of. You know, and these things come without advertisements. You can buy the app if you want. And then you also support the developer, of course. It's also a great thing. It's good to have a non-commercial application store as well installed. That comes from good hands. Android police is checking these files, you know. So yeah, I mean, like, I trust Android police. These guys, they know whatever they are talking about and what they are doing. if they're gonna share something to you, it's always good. You don't have to worry that something is not good in there or so. There you go. At 9:19, we were done. So let me show you how to set it up real fast, okay? You go next, of course. You set your language and your location. Don't connect to Wi-Fi yet. Did we root? Yes, we rooted. Next. Skip. Start. And there we go. Boom. And you can choose out of Launcher 3 that I left in here. I removed the old Trebuchet, updated it with Launcher 3. But we also have Open Launcher. And I would go for Open Launcher if I was you, because then you can get the spy looks, okay? So go for Open Launcher. And then you hit Always. Okay, now you don't see anything. That's just fine. Long press. Settings. Yeah? And then you're going to go to Appearance. And then you select Icon Pack. And you go for the Oreo icon pack. You say allow and you select it again and you're done. Okay, you go one back and then you go to app drawer. It will be vertical. You can set the style to vertical and paged if you want. I like paged. You can go ahead here and here the card view. Okay, select it and put it to black. Like that, okay, and the labels you're gonna leave white. So now, in fact, you're done here. You're gonna go to the home screen, and now you're gonna see the result. Yeah, you're gonna go up, boom, and there you go. So you just fix the icons, of course. Now you will have the pleasure to go ahead and long press the icon that you want to have on your desktop. Okay, this will be, of course, the camera. App. We had to go like this. The camera app. You want it right there, right? You want the browser there. And there you want to have your messages, right? Or am I wrong? So where are the messages? They should be here somewhere. Messaging. And then you put the messages there. So now you have a kind of nice desktop, okay? To change the wallpaper, yeah, you will have to go to settings. But before we're gonna go to settings, we first go to Substratum. It will ask for root permission. Could not file a call back to rooted mode. Okay, let's see what's wrong with Magisk Manager. Magisk is not installed, okay? So that is kind of strange, because I thought that we flashed it. I'm 100% sure that we flashed it, but no problem. We're gonna go to the settings first. We called it here. It's called, I think, Instellingen. Where is it? There, settings. Oh yeah, we are on English. We go all the way down, about the phone, build number. We tap it. You have enabled developers options. You go one back. And then you go here and you tap auto advanced restart. Can you see that there? That is kind of handy. Root access disabled. Okay, that's kind of strange. We flashed Magisk restart back into recovery. Let's do it again. Sometimes you need to do it two times. Install upper level up and away in my beautiful balloon. SD card. I find it very strange that my touch is working so stupid. Or this Magisk version is not good. This could also be the case. I'm not sure. Or maybe it's the error that we're getting at could not mount image. unable to mount storage. What storage is it talking about? Reboot system. Let's see if now we have root access. Still a nice phone. The G3. The G4 is very nice, eh? I saw it today. You could see it in my MediaMarkt video. These phones are getting really beautiful these days, eh? This is very normal. You first get a black screen and then boom, you pop in. Okay, so don't worry about it. And let's see if we have root now, because it's kind of strange that we have no root. Magisk. Okay, root is installed. Fine. So now you're gonna go to Substratum. So first install the ROM and then reboot back into recovery and then install the root, okay? I was booting Substratum. There it is. It wants a little. Let's do it again. Let's try it again. Substratum. There it goes. It's gonna ask for root. Wait. Okay, it was denied. You see? Magisk denied it. So just go to Magisk. These things you must know. And then you go here and you go to super user. And it says no app found. Then just go to super user and set the settings. Let's put it to dark theme. That looks nice with the system. And then super user, we set it to apps only. Okay, you see that? So we had to change that, we had to fix that in the super user. Only owner has root access, that's very good. So now we go back to Substratum and now it should get. Let's try it again. It should knock on the door again. Okay, it says could not fall back to rooted mode. That is stupid. All these problems I did not have before. So this is kind of strange what is happening now. But then again, the newer these versions get. There it is. We just had to enable it. So now it's enabled. And we go to Substratum. We turn it off again and we pop it on again. Could not fall to rooted mode. There are no other theme engines available. What is it talking about? We have root. Oh, this Magisk 18.1. I wished I never. I that's why I install my old versions, because these things, it turned off again. It just turned it off. How is this possible? This is kind of failing. This is pure crap. What is happening now? This Magisk version is. I don't know. Look, it's turning it off again. You see that? It's terrible. Yeah, super user is granted. You know? Let's go to settings. Super users apps only, that is good. And prompt grant. Okay. Let me see something. I'm gonna put it back soon too. To ask. Okay, you see, now it works. Okay, allow. And we get this theme, okay? And then you go ahead and install selected. You see the things that I did just now to get back to the system? So now the only thing that you need to do is reboot the system, because if you're going to go to the settings now, it's not going to be black. You see that? So we're going to reboot again, restart. It was kind of crazy with the Magisk just now. I hope it will not reset it back to not rooted. Otherwise, just use Magisk 17 or so, okay? Don't go for the latest. I packed the good version in a zip. So, you're gonna have a good version. In fact, this version what I installed is not that good. And if we go to the settings now, we're gonna have nice dark settings. You see, so this is how to set up the RAM. About the wallpapers, yes, I also did something for that. You go to the settings, and then up here you're gonna hit change wallpaper, okay? And here you're gonna see that I have a nice little, let me see where it is. Okay, in some way these were not implemented, or maybe I forgot to do so. Okay, never mind. Let's go to the firewall. Let's turn it on. Okay, applying firewalls rule successfully granted root. Okay, meaning that if you're gonna tap any icon, any app, you know, means that app will not be able to go onto the internet. So you can go through all the applications that you don't want them to go onto the internet. Okay, that includes things like the FM radio, doesn't need, no, you know, Magisk can stay home, the icon pack can stay home, root browser can also stay home, Termux can stay home, that is a terminal emulator. This one can also stay home. We're not gonna use the Termux. That is only if you want to install Linux into the system, then Termux is already installed, okay? It's only for guys that want to install Linux. They already have Termux. You will need it if you want to install Linux onto a phone like this. Here you can see we also have YouTube. Yeah, this iOS music player, you can also block it. Substratum, you can also block, okay? If you're not gonna install other themes, just block it. It will save a whole lot of headaches. And then, oh yeah, then you hit the little arrow. It's gonna say firewall updated rules successfully. And then in fact now, you can go ahead and connect to the internet. About the wallpapers, yeah. I'm sorry, I thought that I inserted a nice wallpaper app, but I failed. As usual, I forgot something again. I'm sorry for that. So find yourself a nice little wallpaper app and, you know, help yourself, I would say. Then you have something to do as well. Live wallpapers. We don't have no live wallpapers. Oreo pack icon. These are icons, you know. Change wallpaper pack. And the best that I can say is go to wallpapers. And up here, you might find a nice one. I like this one. Most of the times I use this one, home and lock screen. It's very nice. Or you could go for this one. It's also very nice, this one here. Set wallpaper, home and lock. It's a very nice sunny wallpaper that will make you kind of happy. If you want the icons a bit bigger, just go to the settings and go to display. Okay, and in display you go to not font size but display size. Okay, and you set it to the max, one step higher. And when you go back to the home screen, the icons will be bigger. You see that? And yeah, that's it. I think it's a very nice room. And all credits once again to G-Man. He's the main maintainer. And of course, Fautisal. Here you can see. This is the developer. His name is G-Man. See that? DJ E-Man. I call him G-Man. G-Man. It's the man of the G, you know, the G3. So yeah, I hope you like this room. I'm sure you do. And if you don't, then I'm very sorry for you. But I like it. I don't like it. I love it. That's very right. I love it. I'm very happy with this room because now this phone is updated and I feel that, yeah, it's very stable. It looks amazingly beautiful. I think the Oreo Pie remix looks nice. The ROM, the official one, you can get from the website. Link will be there. It's just like me, a Google Drive that the guys are putting this onto. So yeah, no advertisements, no banners, no link to click, and then you know you must enable and things start playing in the background. Nothing like that. These are real developers. So thumbs up once again, G-Man and Fautisal. And yeah, go ahead and leave them a thumbs up there for the ROM. Okay, thank them for updating it and that you can download it. Go ahead there and find the official Lineage OS that they created. Well, official, it's not official, but the official one from these guys. And check out the other Google download link that will be straight up to this ROM that is effect the same ROM but only modded to look, yeah, kind of different. Very beautiful, to say this way. And you're also gonna have great applications installed that will also, yeah, entertain you immediately. You can watch live TV from out of the box. From out of the box. You can immediately watch YouTube whenever you connect to the internet. Well, let me show these things real fast to you, because maybe it's I'm saying it all, but yeah. In fact, I should also show it, how it all works. So I'm gonna connect to the internet real fast. Okay, we are connected. Let me bring you once again a little closer to the show. So we are now connected to the internet. It's saying no internet, but that's because my firewall is it's crying about that, you know, for the first second. So YouTube, for instance, you see that? Just tap a video. You see that? It starts playing. So you, in fact, don't need no Google services to run this YouTube. It's a special one that was developed by, what is their name again? I always forget. You can see it when you boot it up. Hold on, let me show that once again. Close all these apps. YouTube by Parafron team. Okay, so this was by Parafron, and it works amazingly good. All right, we also have Dutch TV for my Dutch people. My Dutch people love to watch Dutch TV. A warning, do not update this application. Don't update it ever, because the version after this one needs Google services, and you know, rooted users cannot watch no TV. That's just how it is. You know, we are being pimped off by by these guys a bit. If this does not play, go to settings and say here to use mobile data and alternative player, empty cache, and then it's gonna reboot the application. And it could also be that I see that it got even more empty up here. So I'm not sure, maybe they're not playing, it's not working anymore. It's terrible, they killed it. I'm very sorry about that for my Dutch people. Ja, ze hebben eindelijk de app kapot gemaakt. Or maybe I blocked it in the, let me see, in the firewall. Maybe by accident I blocked it. Where is my firewall? Oh ja, there. Maybe I blocked it by accident, let me see. But I don't think so. No, it was not blocked. Damn it. Let me see. Where are these things on? No, I think it's over. I must ask a developer to hack the new application that they have, and so we don't, you know? Or I should connect the government and tell them that this station, NPO, National Public Station, that it's, discriminating. Because we, Android users that don't use Google services, we are being discriminated. We must use Google. We are forced. It's like, somebody's putting a gun on your head, like you must. Otherwise, it won't happen. And that's very sad, that we are being treated that way. Because this is national public television, and it should be able to be to you should be able to watch it with every browser, with every phone. It doesn't matter if you have Google services installed or not. This is really pimping of the people. This, I'm gonna make a case of this. I'm gonna make one big thing of this, really, because they are not allowed to do this. This is really, they are not. You cannot do that. Radio is still playing, probably. But in fact, this is Dutch radio. You can, for my Dutch people. I'm very sorry that they lost their TV. We also have Radio Droid. This comes from F Droid. This, up here we have all the stations as well. World stations, Suriname, everything is in here. USA, name it. All countries of the world. So this fantastic application. We have scanner radio. You can listen to scanners all over the world. Out of the box. So this is a beautiful phone. And in fact, I cannot stop it. Okay. Okay, I stopped it. So de zijn kleine kinderziektes die eventjes na een paar klikken zichzelf oplossen. You have open camera, you have a good recorder to record music. If you are in some rehearsal room with your band or so, you can even set the input volume, the microphone source, the microphone sample rate, 44 kilohertz, of course, the encoding, you can set it to wave if you have enough space. Okay, and you can even set the volume of the recording somewhere here. Where was it again? Here you can set the recording. If the thing is recording too loud, set it to 30%. And then it's gonna record even better, you see? So if things are too loud, you put them softer. If they are too soft, you put them louder. So that's how it should be. We have two app stores, APK Pure and F-Droid in here. So you have grayscale. This thing has an AMOLED screen. So with root, you can get grayscale on here. You see that? And now your battery will last very, very long. This is all thought of, you know, all these applications I thought of. You have Bitdefender up here that will protect you. You have Bootbox, you can create boot animations. Tell me a ROM that comes like this. Not even one. And you also have, what was I saying, Bitdefender. Bitdefender will scan your device, allow, and start scan, and it's gonna scan. And if any virus or malware application is trying to install, that thing will block it, really. This is amazing. So I think this is, again, a beautiful ROM, and I hope many of you will love it. Okay, now I'm really gonna stop the video because my rotis are probably burning in my pan there, so I must, you know, eat a little bit. So I wish you good luck with your G320FN. Links will be in the description. If you think this video was cool, leave it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and then I see you in my next video again. Until then, bye bye.